Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Today I'm talking about Botox and cheap Botox particularly. Four things to keep in mind when you're considering where to go for your treatments and the price of your product. I'm tackling this because the number one question we get asked, as you see below in these videos, is often on price. And it's also the number one question that's asked when people call clinics, and this isn't new, this has been for 20 years. Hi, how are you? How much is your Botox? So let's start there. Let's go through pricing and some things to keep in mind aside from pricing and why pricing may be the way it is. First, a little bit about Botox. We use Botox now as a verb. People say Botox it, Botox. There's three different kinds of Botox. Botox is a brand. We also have Dysport and xeomin. Botox comes as 100 units. Dysport is 300 units, xeomin in 100 unit vial. They're all reconstituted with water. So one of the things that comes up is dilution. They're all diluted. They're not interchangeable by units. It's very artistic how you use it, where you use it, and how it is converted. So with that in mind, what are four things to keep in mind about pricing? Number one, you can never tell if you're actually getting the units that you are. And the first point is you never will actually know because it's a liquid. As I mentioned, they're all diluted with saline. When you take it out of the vial, there's no way that you'll know exactly, if you wanted to, what it is. Think of like a gallon of gas. When you go to the gas station, you don't fully know that you got 4.3 gallons. There's variability. And if someone wanted to cheat you out of some gas, you'd never know other than a rough gauge of your gas meter, and the rough gauge might be your result. So there's no way for a patient to know, did they get 20 units, 25, or 15? Number two is variability. And I alluded to that the result is what you're looking for, but there's variability. What do I mean? There's variability in the body's response. So you could get 20 units today, have a great result, get 20 units in 3 months, and get a so-so response for one of many reasons. One is the body is going to react a little bit differently every time. It's a drug, it's the body, and the body responds. The second, there's some degree of variability in every vial, and there's data to suggest that. So while a product might be 100 units in a vial, maybe there's 110, maybe there's 90, maybe there's some variability within the product that's being given. The third point is the product itself. Now, when you mix it up, you have to really use it within 2 to 3 weeks, maybe towards 4 weeks, but after that, the curve of efficacy drops off, meaning it becomes less effective. So if you go somewhere that mixed the product up or used it last several weeks ago, it's not gonna be near as effective as somebody that mixed it up today or within a week or two. And so there's variability within the products. You might call up and say, oh yeah, we have it. It's $10 a unit here. You don't know how long that product's been mixed up. If you're going to a place that's doing a lot of injections and doing a lot of treatments, chances are they're going through product. But that's a variation and a variability that the patient cannot measure. Number four is the handling of the product. So xeomin can be stored warm. If you take Botox or Dysport, they need to be stored cool. And there's some differing evidence on this. Some people believe that, for instance, Botox can be kept at room temperature for a while. I've done this for a long time, and over 20 years, I've seen so many things happen, from strikes in the postal service to snowstorms to a product being stuck over the weekend and you get it warm. And we always try these things, especially 20 years ago. We didn't know the intricacies of the product, the little nuances. And I've even had product in a warm car for 4 hours, mix it up and tried it, and it didn't work. So we know that the storage and the handling of the product before it's even reconstituted changes the effectiveness of the end product. So there's four points to keep in mind when you call and you ask, how much is a unit of Botox? What information does that really give you? That becomes the question. Do you know about the product, its effectiveness, and does that unit per dollar per unit really mean something to you? Thanks for joining me here. Join us on Instagram. Join us here on this YouTube channel by subscribing for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.